This is a Thor News presentation. Thor News presents
as an investor, John Q. Public was angry, confused, scared, bewildered. He didn't know what was going on. He had done everything right, and he'd lost all of his money. He invested it wisely. Buy Apple, they said. It's the most innovative company in America, they said. He could remember back to when his wife was alive, filled with passion, joy, and happiness. Their investments were worth a lot of money. Their stocks were worth a lot of money. Their house was worth a lot of money. Passion and life were alive. They were a happy couple before Wall Street showed up unannounced. In 2008, spoiled the whole party. John Q. Public had his house be his bank account and his nest egg, and his 401k, well, his corporation went under, and he found out that they'd filled his 401k with Lehman Brothers bonds, Bear Stearns bonds, Countrywide bonds, Merrill Lynch bonds, Bennigan's bonds. So it was worthless. He knew now to get back in the game, the only place to get a good return was in stock. He knew he'd have to get back in. Wall Street was so good at this game, he didn't know how to compete. And the stress was a killer. Could kill your life, kill your marriage, kill your passion. And few things are more stressful than being broke. So he sat there, angry at the world, had no answers. John Q. Public knew the only way to beat inflation would be to get into stocks and equities. So he asked his friend, and his friend said, "Well, just buy the dip in the stock market." John Q. Public said, "Which dip should I buy?" And his friend laughed and said, "The one 6 years ago." He knew the run-up of the stock market and the quantitative easing liquidity flood had basically passed him by. Now they were tapering. John Q. Public hung his head in despair, crestfallen and brokenhearted, reaching his nadir moment. Angry at the world, had no answers, while government, Wall Street, inflation, gas prices, or sitting on his couch, feeling his money up, putting their hands on his money's ass, fondling, manhandling, and about to take everything. And then John Q. Public remembered Forrest Gump. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. And he looked on TV and saw that in the Super Bowl, there were the Seattle Seahawks and the Denver Broncos. And both of those states had legalized recreational marijuana use. And at that moment, John Q. Public knew, oh my God, the marijuana industry is gonna be the new bubble. And that bubble hasn't even begun. And so John Q. Public began to fight back. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. It's bad luck. Have both thy name. And I wanna welcome you to Thor's Super High Hedge Fund. I live in Texas, where it is still against the law to smoke a joint, but it is totally 100% legal to purchase marijuana stocks and equity. Marijuana stocks might turn out to be better than gold. You follow me? And this allows us to get in on the dirt level, where they're just now starting to plant the seeds. So that's what we're doing here, ladies and gentlemen. We're just gonna learn about economics, fiscal policy, investing, financial instruments. And you might be saying, why would I listen to this YouTube dumbass? You're right. Why don't you go off and listen to Goldman Sachs, Kermit? Who knows, maybe Warren Buffett will give you some of his greatest ideas. Betting against bonds.